Well, expert committee to match up the existing online courses and identify gaps and develop material as per UGC's model of choice-based credit system of curriculum. And the Apex Education Regulator has also said the same in the latest reports. Now we have joining to Sharma from the correspondent from Delhi. We have today to discuss something more about the online classes. Well, hello, sir. So, what is all about online classes so far, sir?
Yes. Yeah, nowadays the online classes are really taking their shape into different. I mean, they are coming as the alternative to this regular classroom coaching.
Yes, sir.
And the situation in almost all the states of India is such that the COVID has just showing some signs of getting off, but the experts from AIIMS are saying that there will be a second peak or a second wave of this particular COVID. So everyone has to be very careful. And as the monsoon is also affecting almost all the states of India, we are, except some coastal states, we are really feeling worried that the wetness might really add to the course of this particular COVID virus, because it is the most favorable time for the virus to spread like anything. So the health experts are also giving some warnings that the school reopening at this particular stage might really have some effect upon the health of the children, who are really so tender, cannot, and they are not expected to have the enough immunity to fight against the virus. So they have given their own health report to the Ministry of Education, and the Ministry of Education also has convened some meeting 2 weeks back, and they have come to some conclusion that this present situation, though seeming to be less alarming, has still the presence of virus going on beneath. So they have clearly given indications that every state has to take into its own fold the present situation in that particular state and take a decision accordingly.
Yes.
Because the climatic, the geographical, and the demographic situations of each state are different, completely different sometimes from the other. I think you agree with this.
Yes, sir. Yes. So,
yes.
Sir, can we understand the basic difference between the traditional classroom and the virtual classroom?
Exactly, because the traditional classroom teaching is such that there the influence of the teacher, the personal influence, the personal care, the personal attention of the teacher really matters. The teacher with his or her eye would really watch upon every student. They have a track of every student as to who is really quite attentive to the studies and who needs some kind of a push-up. So they have their own kind of analysis, and once they enter the classroom, basing on those things, they deliver that particular lecture or the lesson to the classroom. And the personal influence of the teacher is such that they teach, apart from the lessons, so many other things like moral qualities, the ethical values, and the way one has to conduct with other students or with the elders or with the staff or with everyone. So such qualities the students imbibe only looking at the teacher, who is the perennial source of inspiration in all these aspects. Because teacher, as you all know, in our tradition, is a very revered person, because he gives us the learning, he gives us the knowledge, he gives the wisdom, he enlightens us, he in fact opens us to the very world in which we live. So the profession of teaching is considered to be very, very holy and hoary in our tradition, and the teacher, even in the present situation also, is commanding great respect. And the students, just by looking at the teacher, they learn so many things, which they all would miss if they are made to learn from the online system, which is being employed presently. So that shows there is a remarked difference between this online teaching and personal teaching. And presently, every educationist is agreeing to this. Almost 3 months, and now also
True, sir.
Democracy has not yet been achieved.
Correct.
The people have lost their jobs, they are unemployed, they have lost their professions, and most of them are being left out. So the society is slowly trying to limp back to its original situation, but it will take a long time.
Yes,
so,
sir, true.
This is the fundamental difference between online and this personal teaching.
Sir, in no time, like about in 3 months or 2 weeks, probably September 2nd week, schools are all set to reopen, sir. So
yes,
government
sir
is also planning for the same. And so do you think it will be a supportive decision in this time of cases of coronavirus also surging day by day?
Yeah, I think the government has an opinion that the people during all these days have come to some kind of awareness regarding this particular situation, and they are well equipped, not only themselves, but also they have taught all these things to, they have conveyed everything to their children also, their wards, as to how they have to social distance from others, how they have to sanitize, how they have to remain aloof, how they have to wash their hands frequently, and how to connect with others. All these things the government expects that by now everyone is aware of. So instead of losing the precious academic year, what it is trying to do is that it is trying to just experimentalize with the situation wherein only a part of the class is allowed during shifts. Some people come in the morning, some in the afternoon, and some in the late afternoon, like that. Some 3 or 4 segmentations of the same classroom will be made, so that the classroom of 20, if it is having some 7 to 8 students, it can accommodate them according to social distance and would find it very easy to give the lessons without any harm to their health. And the government has also said that even in the governmental schools, the digital classroom teaching should be employed. So that is also one thing which everyone is aware of, and that would really add to some help. But we have to really wait and watch with caution, because the situation is still not yet under control. So every parent is very anxious whether to send their children to the school or not, and it needs to be known only in the later part of this month.
Well, sir, what is the most common challenge for the students to attend online classes?
Yeah, the common challenge is, first of all, the children, when they are in the classrooms, that so this is a situation, this is a situation which everyone has to understand. And later, even if you make the student focus upon the lesson also, there are other factors like the communication between the teacher and the student will not be the same as we find in the classrooms.
True,
suppose a student is not able to understand any particular instance, he cannot raise the question immediately, because I have seen with my personal observation that some students, they raise their hands before the cam. But that is not being noticed by the teacher, because teacher is addressing almost 100 students at a time. So the screen will be so tiny, cannot give time or opportunity for everyone. So that is also happening. So in that situation, it is finding very difficult. So the student is really struggling. That too, it is really painful to the eyes also. The tiny, tender eyes have to focus constantly upon this electromagnetic screen, which is really dangerous and detrimental to them. And all these things would really make the student. And one more thing I have forgotten to tell you.
Sir,
the most important thing is, as they are made to sit before the system for a long time, most of the students are turning obese also. The case of obesity is also increasing among the students nowadays, because they are at a place for a long time. There is no physical movement, physical activity, or kind. There is no, tendency for them to move out of the place. So they are fixed up in their own homes, and that too before the system. So the complications of obesity, like gastric problem and other acidity and other allied problems, are also cropping up with the students. And most important thing is that the students, because they are locked up in their own homes, are having a kind of psychological alienation from their peers. And that is really proving quite detrimental, because if the student is having a kind of trouble, psychological abnormality, that would really tell upon his health, and that would really prove detrimental in the long course of life ahead. So all these things are there. So every parent is really anxious nowadays, and most of the parents, those who are economically not well off, are really struggling to provide the electronic gadgets which are needed to provide the basic facility, this connectivity to the classes. Most of them have to get it from outside or borrow from others, the necessary laptops and Wi-Fi connections, and all these things are really telling upon, because they are not having the enough economic support during these days. So it's a very tricky, dangerous, and very decisive situation we are in. And I hope things would really change in course of time, maybe in
yes,
a couple
sir,
of
even
weeks
I'm
or
expecting
so.
The same. So, sir,
yeah.
Like as the schools are set to begin shortly,
mm-hmm.
what kind
yes.
of measures does the management need to take to ensure a healthy education surroundings?
Yeah, definitely the managements have been given strict instructions by the governments, respect to state or central governments, that the classroom should be as tiny as possible. And one more thing, everything has to be done in kind of shift, and necessary arrangements should be made for frequent hand wash, sanitization, and social distancing has to be made. It is made mandatory because the children have the tendency to meet each other, greet each other, connect to each other, touch each other physically. So teachers have to put in extra care, extra effort, and they have to really observe them every now and then, so that no two students sit together or exchange the material or touch each other. And the worst part is during the lunch break or the recess, these students have the tendency to mingle with each other, and during the lunch hour they have a tendency to share from the others. So that should be completely avoided. Even the water bottles should be picked up by each one from their own bags. So that type of command should be given from the teachers to the respective class students, so that the interaction between them is completely eliminated and they are safe enough to receive the lessons from the school teachers. So
right.
that has to be made to the area.
So sir, for the school goings, there are around 6 subjects, and previously
yes.
they used to around 45 minutes for each subject and certain limited time for the PT and all. So
yes.
as the students needed of social distancing, which is a necessary aspect after this COVID lockdown reopenings of schools. So
yes.
how the management are going to focus on in timing maintenance, sir?
Yeah, definitely, as the central government has already indicated that the syllabus will be truncated at least by 30% this year. So the number of hours and the number of lecture hours will naturally come down
okay.
correspondingly. So the classroom timing also will be shortened.
Mm-hmm.
And as the students are made to come in shifts, naturally they will be made to stay only for 3 to 4 hours at the school. That is only to have some kind of connectivity going on.
Mm-hmm.
Only for that purpose they will be made to come to the school and receive whatever little the teacher gives to them in that particular time. So the normal operations of the school will not be there in this particular academic year.
Mm-hmm.
Everything will be, syllabus will be truncated, classroom timing will be truncated, and so many other corresponding and allied changes will take place, because there will be no public physical fitness classes, and the other cultural activities will not be there, because there the tendency to interact with each other will be more. So such things will be eliminated, only the classroom coaching will be there, and even handling of the children from school to their respective homes through the school buses also, that is a very big thing, because even in the bus also sanitization has to take place, and the students should be made to sit in different seats. That also has to be taken into consideration. Every aspect of the student should be taken very seriously by the school management, because even a single lapse would crop up a series of infections, not only to one student, but if one student catches something, you would not be able to reveal, or you would not be even in a position to understand that he is affected. So naturally he mixes with others, and that would spread into a kind of wave. So the school has to be very, very cautious with respect to the students. Elderly people can at least say that they are finding a kind of difference with respect to their health, which the younger ones will not be able to notice. They just go according to the ways of the others. So they just imitate and go by the others. So they cannot identify what is happening within them.
Correct.
This has to be noticed by the teachers. If they find that some student is having a serious headache or some eye pain or any other abnormality, indigestion or any other kind of temperature rise, immediately he should be isolated. He should be given separate treatment and he should be taken to the local doctor. It should be checked for whatever is there and should be found out and should be medicated accordingly. See, the situation worldwide is so alarming that this is not particular to India. Even the schools in UK are also employing so many doctors, in-house doctors in every school. There they have made it mandatory in US that every residential doctor should be there, so many number per so many students. They have given a ratio also, like 1:25. For every 25 students, one doctor should be there who will be constantly and continuously taking care of the health of the particular students assigned to him. So such a situation we cannot have, because ours is a developing country. So here teacher has to take the extra responsibility of looking after the health of the students, and they have to really see to it that the student does not suffer from any kind of abnormality. So all these things have to be taken care of.
Well, sir, in the risky situations like this, which is very difficult to handle kids at the schools or in maintaining social distancing and all norms to be get followed, and then why can't we continue the online education for this academic year?
Yeah, this is a wonderful question, because there is a kind of 50-50 discussion going on, and as most people want the natural classroom teaching because they find that their wards are really getting affected by the online teaching, and the online teaching is also not being proved successful for the primary and senior level students because they are not accustomed to these ways of teaching. The upper class students like beyond 10, they might benefit from such kind of teaching, but the lower class students are really fine. They are not able to follow the lessons. They are not able to understand because there is some kind of voice problem, sometimes video problem will be there. The connectivity in the lesson will be lost. There will be no occasion to raise the doubt. And most of the time as spending before the system is not good for the students. So the parents want the classroom teaching to take place at the earliest, that too with all these restrictions. As most of the parents feel that this is better, government has also made a kind of experimental consideration for the same. And if this turns out to be really worse or dangerous, then government might take some steps towards the end of this year, most probably by December. They have kept it some 3-month time as the observation time. If everything goes well, they would continue with that. Otherwise, they will completely abandon this and they would go to the online education as that is being followed presently. So government is also two-minded. They cannot enforce, they cannot strictly say that online coaching should take place the entire academic year because students are not able to derive any profit out of it. At the same time, they cannot force students to attend the classrooms because there is some risk of getting infected. So it's a proposition between these two things, which the government is taking care very cleverly, and they are, with the help of these educationists and other sociologists, they have come to some conclusion that they might give a chance to the students with all these restrictions to appear before the classroom for quite some time and see the results. And if everything goes well, they would continue with that. Otherwise, they would revert back to the online teaching. So that's their strategy.
That's a great thing, sir. But here, when we talk something about the students and the classrooms,
yes.
So now it's been almost since March, students are not at all visiting any classrooms, like they are completely confined to homes. So, do you think students will have certain interest to come and attend the traditional classrooms after this long gap? And if we continue online classes, what kind of impact we have to observe among students when they have to get back to traditional classrooms? How hard it would be for them to get back to the normal life once again?
Yeah, this is exactly what the psychologists are speaking about the students who are suffering due to this online classes. Because psychologists, they fear that if the students are held back in their own homes for quite a long time or protracted time, they might completely lose interest in going to any classroom further. They might completely detach themselves from the traditional system of education. Because already children are less reluctant to go to the schools, leave the home and go to the schools. And if this opportunity is widened, then they might completely lose interest and might even abandon studies. So they want to have some kind of connectivity, at least some 2 hours in the schools and the rest through online classes or through some online support. The psychologists are giving strict warnings to the parents that the student should at any point of time lose interest in the studies. That is of paramount importance. This is the thing which everyone should keep up. The motivation should be there, and it is hardly found in the homes because most of the parents are busy with their work, and in this particular scenario, everyone is struggling to find some source of income and they are lost in that. So there will be no occasion for any parent to motivate the student to take interest in the lessons. And
Well,
that is
sir,
what the psychologists fear.
yes, sir. Sir, on the same line as we're talking about the psychology of students, parents, and teachers, so here,
Yes.
like, what kind of changes do we observe from the concentration? Like, if we talk about teachers, what kind of activeness and the enthusiasm is still in rest with the teachers today? Because to attend a certain classroom, teacher used to get excited, naming few students of her class,
Yes.
memorizing all the stuff and all. So,
Yes.
but now the situation is completely different. They are just confined to screens, and the interaction between the student and the teacher is completely has a breakdown with this virtual. Digital era, which has started for all of us sudden due to COVID. And
Yes.
then, what is the condition of students? So, how does both can be counseled? Like, how students and teachers can be counseled to get back to the normalcy?
Yeah, this is a very important aspect which you are talking about, because we have all along been looking only from the point of view of the students. But the most interesting thing is the aspect of the teachers themselves, because the teachers were used to giving the lectures offline in the classrooms, and now suddenly they are being made to appear before the screens, as you said, and that change is not as easy as is said, because so much of mental preparation is required, and in some cases, it is not only the mental, apart from mental preparation, the teachers, those who are not in touch with these latest things like handling the laptops or these PowerPoint presentations or these lectures before this type of media are finding it really difficult. They need to get acquainted with all these things. And I have seen in few cases that the teachers, due to their less acquaintance with this particular system, are finding it very, very difficult, and they find that they can no longer present their views properly because they are into strange situations suddenly, and that forces them to really take a second look at this profession itself. I have seen some personal cases where some teachers have left their jobs in search of some other professions. Even that worst scenario is also taking place, and to prevent all these things, the school managements are providing a kind of interactive sessions, counseling sessions with the teachers, so that they find it easy to walk through this particular type of media-based teaching.
Yes, sir.
And in some cases, as you have said, both teachers and students are finding it difficult because teachers are not able to report what is in their minds properly, and even the students are also not in a position to receive properly. So both ways it is affecting the teachers and the students as well. And this particular thing could only be averted if they are made to, with all the preventive measures, if they are made to interact even for 2 or 3 hours a day, they could learn at least something. The educationists, when they made a survey as to how effective the educational system through online, found to their dismay that most of the students at the primary level have reported that they have understood nothing out of the online classes. Except for spending some time before the systems, they could understand nothing.
Correct,
so, this is a very serious warning to all the online classroom holders, because when the student is not able to learn anything out of that particular educational or learning process, what is the fun in conducting such a thing? It needs to be abandoned at the earliest. So now, taking all these measures, the government is seriously planning to open up the schools only to make the students sit in the classrooms for a limited period of time, and during that limited period, whatever is possible, the teacher would convey. Always, as everyone says, as the records also say, personal education by the teachers in the classrooms is the best, and it can never be matched with the online education. That is for certain, and it has been proved during this COVID period also. Everyone says that this is the just temporary makeshift arrangement, because the student should not lose any kind of connectivity with the learning process. These online classes are being arranged, but it cannot go on for the entire academic year. Maybe for 2 or 3 months it's okay, but it should not be continued for the rest of the academic year. That is why the government has taken this particular decision to reopen the schools and see if the consequences are within the possible limits or within the range of safety. If it is really going well, then they would be very happy to continue with the same.
Yes, sir. So here, giving a little transformation from students, teachers to the side of parents.
Yes.
So generally, not every parent can afford the education nowadays, because they are not affordable to buy or purchase every kid of their family a particular device to attend their online classes. They might have a system, one computer or one laptop in a family,
yes,
where all of them used to share before. But now, due to the particular class timings and the office timings, they have to share one particular tablet or whatever the device they have among four of them,
yes,
which is turned out to be a very difficult aspect. So, in the regards, how parents can take care, and what are the things they can sacrifice for online education of the students, and where they can get hold of their priorities, how parents should act, sir?
Yeah, this is a very nice thing to start with. Here, we will begin with something like this, because of late, most of the parents are in search of some economic resources. That is a thing which is known to everyone, because most of the regular employment opportunities have gone and most of them are at home only. So they have been searching for some kind of situations where they can work from home. So as you have been telling, there is some tablet or some particular system or laptop in the house, and that is being used by the parents for working from their homes.
Yes, sir.
And if this particular laptop has to be shared by some others, then it would really be a great trouble, isn't
yes,
it?
Sir. Yes, sir.
They have to, if they have to sacrifice it for some 4 to 5 hours to their children or what, that is going to really prove heavy upon them.
Yes,
they have got their own commitments. They have to really give out their own reports or scripts or content to the people with whom they have made some kind of agreement or arrangement. So everything is time based. So within that time they have to give certain report and they will be paid accordingly. That is the thing belonging to this working from home. So in that particular situation, if they have to sacrifice their laptop or system to their wards, that's going to throw really heavy upon them, and that is why the parents are really reluctant. And sometimes to go for the new system, it is going to again prove economically very difficult for them in this particular situation. So parents are in a fix nowadays. The small scale employment and other, those who are really employed in some small things are really finding it difficult because they can't lose their economic resource. At the same time, they can't sacrifice these things for their children's education. So government cannot do anything towards all these things because ours is a developing country and we cannot afford to provide laptop or system to everyone as in some countries it is being done, like in New Zealand. The government itself gives laptop to all the students, but it is not possible here. Our economy has to move up and our ends have to meet. So here in India, every parent is really making so much of sacrifice. They are really spending sleepless nights. They are working late into the night. They are, when the children are asleep, they are taking up their work. And they are really struggling hard to maintain the family, maintain the education of these students. And this is how the present situation is going on.
Well, sir, like the education quality is also completely reduced if we talk. And the content of which the school used to deliver before is completely nowhere relatable with the virtual classrooms content which they are delivering now. And but still the payments of schools are reported to be same and comparatively higher, and comparatively higher burden on parents because they have to provide monthly Wi-Fi chargers and monthly internet data chargers, as well as the extreme to download videos of the teachers which they have uploaded every day, and that internet charges as well, and as well to store all the classes in the phone they have to buy the storage as well, and these charges. So completely, like when compared to the virtual classroom, online classroom turned out to be a very higher burden in the basis of finance as well. So in the regards, how the finance management can be happen, like how a parent need to handle this thing, and whereas management, how they can actually charge online classroom.
This is a very interesting discussion going on in the schools between the respective managements and the parents. Every day some parent, one or two, are turning up to the school and they are having a talk with the management that this particular type of education is proving quite expensive.
Yes,
and
sir.
it is going beyond their reach.
True.
So the school managements have to take a decision to lessen the burden on the parents, because parents are already doing a lot for this education of their children. So from the other end, the school authorities have to take a decision to lessen the burden. Actually, as you have rightly said, even for the online education also, the school fees remains the same.
Correct.
Yeah, this cannot be accepted at all, because here they are not welcoming the students into the classroom. Here there is no opportunity for the classroom education, but still the entire course fee remains the same. It is not going to prove logical. This year they have to reduce it at least by 50%. So that the rest of that 50% could be borne by the parent towards acquiring all the electronic gadgets and other things, as you have rightly said, acquiring hard disk for storing all these things. Extra things are there. For arranging money for all these things, they can really give some kind of waiver. The school authorities have to plan for a waiver. They have to sit with the respective, parents, and they have to arrive at some figure. And that particular waiver would be used by the parents in acquiring all these things. Then it would be even for the parents also.
True, sir.
But now real injustice is going on towards the parents. They are not given any kind of waiver or subsidy or any kind of discount. And they are made to pay the full fee. And apart from that, and on top of that, they are made to acquire all the gadgets, pay for the Wi-Fi, then acquire these things like laptop and connectivity, everything. So it is proving really very difficult. that too in this particular time when their economic resources are fast drying up. They are not having enough to thrive also. Their resources are also getting depleted every day. So in that situation, if they are overburdened, it is a real injustice in the name of education. So I would request all the school authorities to take this serious situation into consideration and try to provide, because all along their students have been paying fees every year regularly to the schools, and the schools are thriving only out of this course fee which is being paid by the parents. So that sense of gratitude should be with the school authorities. Taking this particular COVID situation, they have to come forward and they have to reduce the burden. If this step is taken, naturally this would induce the parents also to send their wards to that particular school for quite some time, because they would feel that these people have understood our pain, agony and the situation, and they have given some waiver. So there will be a kind of a mutual understanding between the parent and the school authorities. That has to be maintained. There should be no friction in the society between any two different domains. Then only the society would run well. This particular thing has to be understood. Even at the humanistic level also, whatever little we can do, even the government should pressurize the private schools to lessen the burden on the parents. They have to issue some GOs to make sure that no private school collects more than what is a stipulated amount set by the government. That should be made very clear. All these steps should be taken to ensure that the parent does not suffer much. Already is put to a lot of suffering. So there is no need to add more to it.
Correct, so, sir. So finally, ending up with the last question here I have. So yeah. Government is planning to broadcast the classes, recorded classes through television channel, the Doordarshan, yes, which we had. And previously they used to do, and now they are yet to begin it back from the next coming week.
Yes.
So do you think it will help the students, and how can we take a poll on it, sir?
Yeah, this is a very interesting question, because the scenario in the government schools is quite different.
Yes.
Unlike in the private schools, the jobs at the government schools are quite secure. So most of the teachers have taken to other occasions during this particular lockdown. Since they are very sure that their jobs are not lost, they are very clever enough to indulge themselves in some profitable ways. And most of them have applied for a very long leave on the, like on some excuse of ill health or some kind of other situation. And they are making a good time out of it. So in the government schools, you can't demand all the teachers to be present at the reopening of the school. Most of them will be missed out. So the government has made a very good decision to give digital classes to the students. In the digital classes, the particular lecture is recorded by an expert teacher, and it is being displayed in all the schools of the government. So a kind of a common trend will be there, evenness will be there, and all students will not miss any lessons due to the absence of the teacher. Whether present or absent, it is immaterial, because it is already recorded version, so it is displayed at that particular hour, and the students listen to it and they grasp. But if they really have some doubt, some teachers who are physically present there might help them. So that is the intention of the government behind bringing back this digital education, because they are not sure that most of the teachers' attendance would be there on rolls once the schools reopen, because most of the teachers are really afraid to come, and most others are interested in taking up their own activities also.
Well, thank you so much, sir. Thank you very much for joining us today. I hope we'll get back on another conversation.